that's what they said, that it is her role to aid humanity and not follow me, which is significant. And we're not seeing it by and large in the culture, right? I don't have to convince you of that. You already know that. So there's certain things, you know, that I process all the time. How do we do that? How do we teach that boldness, right? That skill set. So the vision is like your big sweeping, you know, what is your hope for your graduates? What is your hope for your future that you want everybody to walk out of your institution with? That, right? They're gonna walk out into the world and they're gonna change it. They're gonna help redeem. Our mission, how do we do that? That's the feminine genius, right? We've got all girls here. How do we do that? We do it with what St. John Paul II taught. We help them find their dignity, identity, and gifts as women created in the image and likeness of God, right? And then even beyond that, okay, so that's great. How do you do that? We have to develop a philosophy. So the philosophy statement that's up there is actually Catholic teaching for Catholic schools. That you need to do two things, and this is what's bold and I think confusing. You need to have both a learning and a formation program. Those two things. Most schools, it's just a learning program, really. In fact, we've taken out of like public schools anything that would be like character education because we're not really convinced we want to be teaching people morality for whatever reason. But in a Catholic school, you're supposed to have a learning and a formation program. And you're supposed to be integrating the faith with reason. The Catholic Church, until last year, didn't have anything that was like a rubric for Catholic schools to be able to integrate faith with reason in every discipline area. So there's the Cardinal Newman Society. I don't know if you've heard of the Cardinal Newman Society. Maybe you've heard of Newman Centers on college campuses. It's the same thing. Their investment is in education, and more specifically, in helping students maintain the faith in educational communities. So they got together all the best of the best from the collegiate community and from K through 8, and then high school communities to say, you gotta help us write standards that we can put into curriculum that's K through 12. So last year they finished them. So we have a chance to integrate now more completely with what it is that we're teaching here. And the key thing that they say throughout it all, it's like even the math, you know, they have standards and things that you're looking for. And the science is just really clear with things that you have to put into some of the different courses. But the key thing is having students assess, and this is their language, in accord or discord with Catholic teaching. So the things which agree with it and the things which don't agree with it. And the students have to be able to pick some of those things out. Because what we're finding, and you know this, when they go to the collegiate level and they're sitting in front of professors, I'm smirking because a Michigan State professor is going to be speaking to you tonight. So if you have questions for me, I'll talk to you. But when they go to the collegiate level, we want them to be able to pick those things apart, right? And the things are being taught. When they're working out in the world, we want them to be able to pick those things apart. And when they're with their peer group, really want them to be able to pick those things apart. So now we have a systematic way, at least in education, to be looking at everything that we're teaching and going, okay, are we making sure that we're running through this in every single course that we teach? We've been doing that on our own. We weren't systematic with it, and it wasn't complete. Now there's a way to make it complete. Somebody did the hard heavy lifting for us.